I too want to thank Ms. Tina Schaefer and Nick Deutsch for doing this and allowing me to be part of it. To me, this place right here is pretty much hallowed ground. And it's, you know, it's not like intimidating, but it was really nice to read on the website that the first time they played here, James Taylor and Neil Young both bombed. Yeah. So, it was on the internet, so it must be true. What was it, 2 days ago, maybe, it was the anniversary of the Gettysburg thing in 1863. I remember it was hot that day. But in the history of this country, we've had like a lot of those days. And we have them going on right now. In one more year, it's going to be the 50th, oh my God, the 50th anniversary of the Woodstock concert. It was 1969. Can I see a show of hands of those people who were alive in 1969? Because with all due respect to these spectacularly talented players, I think my strings might be older than some. It's a jealousy thing, trust me. It's a jealousy thing. But when that concert was going on, it was in full-fledged, you know, Vietnam War and such, and it was, it might be familiar to you now because we have a lot of the same sort of stuff going on. And so this song is called Time Takes Forever. It was another Sunday morning in August of 69. School was out, life was good, Bobby had nothing but time. Like every week, Bobby's mom would load up the station wagon, take the kids into Sunday school, okay, maybe not take as much as take, it's dragging. Bobby always wondered why his father never went to church with his wife and kids. When Bobby would ask, his mother would say, "We have our church." And your father, he has his. Time takes forever. It rushes by to disappear. Too late, won't get here soon enough, and the past is no longer here. Future hasn't happened yet. Or maybe it's all done. Everything underneath the bridge flows by to start. Bobby was just 13 years old, somewhere between boy and man. His father's church was a mystery. That morning, Bobby had a plan. He told his mom he'd ride to church with the next door neighbors. Instead, he hid in the floor of the back of Dad's Buick under a blanket and some old newspapers. About 15 minutes after the car started moving, Bobby was sure he should have stayed at home. Especially when he heard his father see him come out now in a measured, even tone. Bobby climbed into the front seat without meeting his father's eye. They drove on for silence for what seemed like forever when they stopped by the river. Bobby didn't know why. See, time takes forever. It rushes by to disappear. Too late, won't get here soon enough, and the past is no longer here. Future hasn't happened yet. Or maybe it's all done. Everything underneath the bridge flows by discarded. By everyone. Bobby's father took a bag from the trunk full of some groceries and one of his old coats. Two of them walked through the woods for a spill, and Bobby's father finally spoke. He said, "Son, in this world, there are lots of things on which we won't agree. You and I have argued a lot lately. mostly even mad at me. But you gotta know when I went away, it wasn't that I wanted to. Sometimes you have to sacrifice. A man's gotta do what a man's gotta do. I led a platoon of 16 men into the mouth of hell. Some didn't come back. I did okay. But some of the other guys, they didn't do so well. They camped out here under the bridge by the river. They call this place their home. It's not the easiest place to live, but by God, it's their own. When we came back from the war, we got yelled at. We got cursed. We got spit on. Funny thing, that war they hated, to be damn sure we hated it worse. So Sunday mornings I come down here to roll call with my men. We have a smoke, tell a few bad jokes, most of all. We don't remember when. Time takes forever and rushes by to disappear. Too late, won't get here soon enough, and the past is no longer here. Future hasn't happened yet, or maybe it's all done. Everything underneath the bridge flows by the start. By everyone. As the years went by, they shared that trip under the bridge on Sunday mornings. Through rain and snow, through thick and thin, and that last time against the doctor's warnings. Bobby often thinks back to those trips he made with his dad way back. And the bond he saw strong as steel between his dad and his men. Then it was the summer of 2009. Bobby's dad had been gone 5 years, you know. Those trips they took under the bridge seemed like a lifetime ago. Because back in the summer of 2004, like Bobby's dad did way back when, in a place they called Fallujah, Bobby's son led 16 more men. See, everybody knew about the war, and most agreed it was a mistake. That last Sunday morning, Bobby's son's platoon came home. Flag draped. That Sunday morning, they were carried to the rest by six strong men and true. Four soldiers who lived under the bridge, Bobby and his dad with the other two. Now Bobby spends every day under that bridge. He's ended his search, but at nighttime, when the darkness falls, he finds a little comfort in his father's church.